First, you know, I'm going to talk about this, and it's we call it Oregon. And of course, I just explained that is that it's terminology. It's any O word means opposite. You know, it's just like in the old days we would say Sally or whatever at, we'd say at a number, and that was just the at part would mean that it was a counter. And so now the we have two primary counters, and our A or B gap counter is Oregon or a Sally, and our C gap counter is Ohio. And then again, you know, down the road, if you want to look at the Buck Sweep and the Ohio are up there on the website. But we run Buck Sweep, and that's really a D-gap counter. We have motion that go, and we have motion go one way, and we run Buck Sweep away. So it's kind of like our three counters. So those are what they're like. Now, Sally Oregon was our best play for a carry this year. We had 17 runs of 45 yards or more. It's the easiest play we have to block by far, and we have a couple simple rules. Now, for those guys that aren't in the gun, this is a great play either way. You can run this play under center, in pistol, in gun. It's just got to be a little bit different blocking in the gun and a different guy carrying the gun. When you're under center and you're doing Sally, the halfbacks are carrying the ball, or if you're in pistol, the halfbacks are carrying the ball. In gun, that's it. Pretty much impossible, so the tailback carries the ball. So that's a little bit what the difference is in what Sally is under center and pistol versus how it's blocked in the gun. We still have the same blocking rules, though, and the O line is pretty much blocking the same. And the basic rules are, number one, if we have a one technique, you know, like a 3-1 and a 4-down defense, you know, we're going to double the one technique, and then everybody else fans. That's the rule. Easy. Double the one, everybody fan. If we have a 3-down defense with a nose guard, we're going to block the nose any way it wants to go, and everybody fans. That's the rules. Pretty easy, pretty simple, easy to carry out. Plus, when you're fan blocking, you've got people walled. So when you get slants, blitzes, you know, angles, you can wall them off rather than having to fight some different way of doing it. So it's a real easy care type blocking scheme. Okay, again, like I said, you can do it in gun and under center or in pistol. So you can do it all that way that's blocked the same. And then, like it says down there, you double the nose and the G defense, fan everybody else, and then you single the nose guard and fan everybody else in an odd defense. Okay, now, under center, it's like this. And we used to call the play, like this, for example, is blue, which is our blue formation, and we still call it blue or bluer. And then it would be 29, which is jet motion, Sally at 3, which would tell us that we're going back to the 3-hole. All right, now what we'd do is we would just call this play Oregon even. And, you know, we go like blue, we just go blue, Oregon even, that's it. And then we would know that it's opposite from the call, which even is to the right. And we just go left. So it's a little easier to call with our new terminology. Anyway, if you're in the center, we put this guy in motion, and every time we put the man in motion, we always snap the ball directly behind the quarterback. Okay? We're going to block the nose. Everybody else is going to fan. Now, this is not how we do it. We would fan this guy. This is what we're doing, Sally at 3. Let me go over the blocking in a minute with another one here. I'm sorry. Here it is in pistol. So what we do is in pistol, we're going to put the motion through the middle of the quarterback and the fullback, run into the sideline. We're going to counter with the wingback. So he would reverse out, and the fullback would block the backside linebacker. Because of the rocket motion or the jet motion, the front side backer is going to run out, so we do not block him. So the second he runs out and he makes the play, that's our counter call. Everybody else is going to fan, so we fan each player and we get them walled. Block the nose where he wants to go, and we come back inside. Okay, so that's how we do it in the pistol. Okay, now I'm going to talk mostly about how we do it in the gun. We attack off tackle, and this is kind of how we read it. We're going to attack off tackle with all our other plays, like our power O or our jet or whatever we're going to do, our buck sweep. And as soon as the backer tries to make the play, the front side backer, by running over the top, and he makes the play, we know that a gap is now uncovered, and we are going to counter with Sally immediately. All right, so this makes play calling easy, and that's what I try to do with the whole offense. When it's sort of a punch counter. If a player makes a play that, away from his gap responsibility, we have a corresponding play to make him hurt. Vice versa, we have plays for inside pressure, outside pressure, rotation slants. This is the play when the front side backer is overplaying jet or overplaying the power O, just cranks out of the box, and now we have a five-man box, and this is an awesome, easy play to hurt that and to make him stay home so your outside runs are better. So that's really how that is, how that's done. All right, so again, it makes selection and adjustments easy and immediate. Okay, formations. Sally's good in all formations, really good, but for us, the ones that we do best in is green and black, which is when we're running with a sniffer. And if you haven't seen that before, I kind of will show it to you tonight. We're now in our offense, we use a sniffer back like Auburn, although they don't have this play. And then, actually, this is the best play that we have. And redder and bluer, which is when we have our tight end in a wide pro set with a wide slot. And it's always best if there's a tight end in the game, but you can run it without that. You can run any formation, but these formations are the best that I think that we run. Okay, here is green formation. So for us, green is we're going to have our Y, which is our tight end. He goes to the sniffer formation. We bring our A and our B back on the same side. The B back is up in the line of scrimmage, and the A is back, and our X is over here. And so what we're going to do is we are going to block it like we always do. And here's an odd defense. We would block the nose, fan everybody else, okay, and the sniffer would go back and counter block the backside linebacker. We hope that this guy is going, the front side backer is going to run out. So that's how it looks like. Now we're going to do a little bit different techniques depending on whether we have motion or we don't have motion. Okay, now we have RPOs off all our runs. So we're going to have RPOs, we're going to have our perimeter players are going to run passing concepts so that if somebody comes off on a blitz or somebody comes uncovered, we're simply going to throw the ball out there to them, and we're not going to carry through with the play. So I'm going to kind of go over what our RPOs are as well. Okay, now we can run it with, and I'm going to go how we do each one. We can run it with motion or without motion. Now we can run Sally with motion, and when we do with motion, usually that play side linebacker is probably going to get out of there pretty good. Now the motion could be jet, it could be rocket, whatever. Usually when we run that, that backer is the guy that's trying to make the play and he's screaming out of the box and we want to stop him from doing that. So what that does, what the jet does is make linebackers run laterally. And so when they run laterally and the front side guy runs off the box and you have the sniffer or the tight end or the fullback if you're under center blocking the backer, backside backer that's shuffling, going lateral instead of filling, you got a heck of a play, and he has a real hard time doing anything or getting off that block. Now, the puller, for us, the puller is going to be, if we are in green and black, the sniffer is the puller, okay? And what he's going to do is, last year we didn't do this, and we found that some people were reading our sniffer a little bit, and it would have been better. We're going to make a hard counter step. So we're going to make a hard jab step with our outside foot. And that should freeze the backer, and that's what we started doing in the spring, and that's worked really well. And redder and bluer, now the tight end really can't pull effectively. So if we're in redder and bluer and we have a tight end and a regular pro type formation, the offensive tackle will pull. And we do the same thing. We are going to take a jab step with him as well, because if it's an odd defense and there's a defensive tackle on our tackle, our offensive tackle, that jab step looks like jet, and it stalls, and we have an easy, he can't run the circle on us. So when we have a sniffer, he's going to be the puller, and when the puller does that, he is, if we are in a G defense, he is going to read that double team. He's going to read the double of the nose, and he's going to fit either inside and outside, wherever that shows, and he's going to go up in the backside linebacker. There's no sniffer, the tackle becomes the puller, and he is the one that's going to do the exact same thing. He is going to fold around, read the one or the nose, and he's going to fit to the backside linebacker. Again, technique is we're always going to take a jab step, so that will freeze the linebacker keying it, or if he's covered, it will freeze the covered defender.